guys, you're watching Cait Straight Up and I am Caitlin, and today we are gonna make King Hawaiian Philly Cheesesteak Pull Apart Bread. It is going to be one big piece of Philly cheesesteak with peppers and onions and cheese and ketchup, and we are gonna pull it apart and eat it. It's gonna be the perfect game day snack. You guys are gonna love it. We are making a pull apart Philly cheesesteak bread. It's gonna be epic. Let's get started. So everyone knows King Hawaiian. I mean, if you didn't know it before Dax Shepard spent his sobriety trip at the factory, you know it now. But if you didn't know about these, I honestly question you, because they are like the most delicious little slider rolls ever. And you could do so many fun things with them. One of the things that I like to do is make a pull apart bread with a variety of ingredients in the middle. Seems pretty straightforward and simple enough. If you don't know about King Hawaiian, you know that the rolls come uncut, all together, and in a nice big block like this. You're gonna start by finding the center and just cutting this entire block in half. So after we get our bread cut in half, we're gonna brown up our meat and just do a quick saute of our peppers and onions. I like to start by doing my meat first. That way, all the flavors of the meat come out in my pan. I just brown it quickly like you typically would brown any other shredded beef. After that, move it to a bowl, and we're gonna cook our onion and our pepper in that fat that came off that meat. We're starting with our onion. Onion takes a little bit longer than pepper. Get it going a little bit before you add your pepper. Then dump your pepper in. We're really just softening up our vegetables so that they're not too hard after our baking, but they do get an extra 10 minutes in the oven, so we're just softening them up a bit. So now that we've done all that, it is time to assemble our epic pull apart Philly cheesesteak. And we need to start with some ketchup. So if you don't like ketchup, I guess you could leave it off. I'm such an immature person. I laugh when the ketchup bottle makes a fart noise. I mean, who doesn't? But we're just gonna go ahead and drizzle some ketchup on top. And if you want to try some other condiments like hot sauce or mustard, I mean, knock yourself out. I like to put a little bit of black pepper on my bread and ketchup. I don't do any other spices in this. I think the fat from the beef and the cooked down vegetables, I think that's plenty, but I do like to do a little pepper. Somehow it just works with the cheese. When I was a little girl, I actually had a thing about this, and I would send my sandwich home uneaten if my mom put my ketchup by my cheese. But on this pull apart bread, I promise it works fine. We're gonna do our cheese layer next. Now on one side, I'm gonna add a Swiss cheese, but you don't have to follow me here. If you think a better cheese would do, go ahead and pick your own. But I like a nice mix of Swiss and provolone. I've done this exact recipe with mozzarella and provolone, but the Swiss pulls apart really nice. It's just like a gooey cheese that kind of goes good with it. So I do Swiss on one side, provolone on the other. My little 8-year-old self is crying in the cafeteria somewhere because the cheese is touching the ketchup, but we all grow up, and I think she would like this pull apart bread just fine. Now the next step is very important. I'm clapping my hands because I am trying to emphasize. You need to build the rest of your sub on one side. If you put meat and peppers on both sides, there's no way you're flipping this bad boy down and covering them up. A little bit of cheese, a little bit of ketchup, you could do it with your hand, flip it easily. No meat, no peppers and onions on your top loaf side. So we're gonna take our browned up shredded steak over here and just spread it out on our bottom half of our King Hawaiian roll. I'm saying it again because you don't want to assemble all this and then not know how to freaking get it together. So make sure all your meat and all your veggies is on the bottom half of your roll. If a little bit gets outside of your pan, it's fine. No need to be perfect. We can always plop it back on top after we get it in, but lay out your meat and then we'll do our peppers and onions. Sometimes there's just no better way to flatten with your hands, so I just kind of like to push it out to the edges with my hands. You could do it with a fork, whatever, just to make it even. Next up, we are gonna sprinkle with our peppers and onions, and same thing, just dump it on top. You could always kind of rework it later. I always eventually kind of end up pushing it down and towards the end a little bit more. So, I mean, really, you lay down that parchment paper so you could be a little bit messy without messing up your pans. So just go ahead, put it on top. So here's that fun part I was talking about, and one of the reasons we put our ketchup down, our cheese kind of sticks to it, and we just kind of fold it back over top. We then move it to the middle of our tray. Again, No worries about any extras on the side. We got that parchment paper. I like to give mine a good press. Make sure it all squeezes together, and we're popping this into a 350 degree oven for about 10 minutes. It could take a little bit longer than that, but what you want is all the cheese to be melting down the sides and looking epic and crazy and Instagrammable. So when your cheese looks like that, and it looks like it's gonna pull perfectly, that's when you know it's done. And boys and girls, it is time to dig in to this Philly cheesesteak pull apart bread. Oh my god. Yes, I'm going for it. Subscribe to King Straight Up. No, I'm kidding. Oh no. It's so much fun. So much cheese, so much flavor. I just love it. Mm. Mm. And the best part about this is you could just keep pulling apart pieces for yourself. And holy crap, it's so good. This looks so good. Mm. Oh my god, I'm getting so mashing. This is so embarrassing. Guys, as always, please make sure to subscribe to Cait Straight Up. It matters. Hit that subscription button. Find me on Instagram, Cait Straight Up Cooking. There's recipes like this every Tuesday, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.